Switching gears now, the Film Development Council of the Philippines International Film Industry Conference returns for its sixth edition. Now this year, it will feature in-person as well as online masterclasses and workshop series to give international and local professionals an avenue to learn and innovate with one another. Now to tell us more about this, we are joined by award-winning Filipino director Jose Javier Reyes. Welcome to the Rundown, sir.
Hi, and good morning. Thank you very much for having me here.
It's good to have you here. Now, things are interesting. In fact, the times are interesting for film and filmmaking with new platforms and even technology itself advancing and expanding ways of telling stories. Tell us, are filmmakers able to catch their breath? And what do you do with all of these possibilities?
Well, it's not only a question of the possibilities, but the given of the here and now, most especially as a result of the pandemic. I mean, the film industry, as most industries in the world, have to realign and recalibrate the way they do things, the way we hope to perpetuate the industry. And this can only be done through an acknowledgement of the existence of technology, as well as a need for global cooperation. I think an understatement is to say that the Philippine film industry is in a major flux, and that we really need the help of our neighbors. And I think the International Film Industry Conference is one way of bridging this gap.
All right. Now, technology may enhance or even change altogether our platforms, our ways of doing things, as you mentioned. But one thing is constant: great storytelling and talented content making. Now, what must they do to set them apart, our filmmakers, from a dime a dozen content makers these days?
Well, one thing is for sure, we can't go back to 2019. Mm-hmm. We can't go back to the ways that we were doing things in the pre-pandemic situation. I agree with you completely. A great narrative is a great narrative regardless of platform. But one thing that the Filipino should realize is that his audience cannot be limited to just his backyard. We have to think globally, and we have to think in terms of cooperation with various cultures, various nations, specifically the Southeast Asian bloc. And this is what will be, I think, greatly emphasized in the IFIC conference right now. The manner we can develop co-productions, the manner we can exchange technologies, so that these great narratives can have a broader audience, an expansive audience. Again, I will repeat, Filipino filmmakers and content creators cannot be content with just creating narratives for their own backyard. We have to think globally.
Right. We've tackled, of course, technology. We tackled storytelling. What about the audience? Did that change?
Tremendously. Streaming has completely changed the equations. We should really stop belittling the masses into thinking that they have a very limited mindset in terms of narrative choices. The accessibility of streaming, the accessibility of the internet has somehow raised the bar. It has somehow raised the consciousness and the level of sophistication of the masses as well. The manner we get entertainment right now is completely different from the way that we did in 2019 and the early 2020s.
Right. So you intend to tackle all of these challenges that you've mentioned, among many other things, during the International Film Industry Conference, which the Philippines is hosting today until Sunday. Tell us more about these events.
Oh, there are so many events. There are various workshops. Okay, there are various open fora which are available online as well as on site. I am part of a panel which will discuss the state of various film industries in the Southeast Asian region. There are seminars on co-production, seminars on marketing. So if you are a filmmaker or a student of filmmaking and you want to know the direction of the future, it's a really interesting venue for you to expand your knowledge.
Yes, yeah, you have a pretty interesting lineup of master classes from industry greats within and outside the country. What do you have in store for everyone interested in the master classes?
It's a matter of opening your eyes to something much broader. For instance, you have the you have the documentary filmmaking, which we are greatly encouraging. Okay, and then opportunities of working with fellow filmmakers, the various incentives given by the FDCP in terms of international co-production as well as local productions. All these will be available, and that you could see the opportunities, you could see the possible choices that you can get into in order to, if not give a jump start, accelerate, but more so redefine your career path.
Yes, Director Reyes, this is the sixth such conference, and there are sessions that are free and open to the public. I'm sure a lot of filmmakers and budding content creators and operators wishing to benefit from, of course, the experience and the expertise of your resource persons. How does one get a slot in the free sessions?
Oh, you just go, okay, you just go to Novotel, okay, register, and you're welcome, okay? And I think what is most interesting is you're going to have a one-to-one contact with all these people, okay, where you can ask your questions, not only online, but in person.
All right, lastly, and perhaps in closing, what are you most excited about as a storyteller in this dynamic age of new platforms, new technology, and even an evolving audience?
You see, I've always considered the pandemic not as a curse, but a source of a challenge.
Right.
And I've always had a mantra, which is shared by the FDCP, that we must accept, we must adapt, and we must advance. I think the IFIC, as well as all the other activities dedicated to the advancement or to the moving forward of the film industry, is only an embodiment of this kind of philosophy. It's, we live in interesting times, and in these interesting times, do we find and redefine ourselves with the inevitability of evolution and change.
Director Jose Villarreyes, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you so much.
Have a good day.